This is Goku Sun, DPC, and welcome back to Top 10 Sunday. And, today will be, of course, Top 10 Video Game Openings. So these will be more or less my own personal picks, that I enjoy very much, like having either, of course, cinematics don't really matter overall, graphically speaking, but having good music and a well-put-together opening is a big deal for this. And, yeah, though music plays probably the biggest role in a really good opening, but also, of course, it needs to make sense, so keep that in mind. And here it is, top 10, coming in at number 10. Original version, of course, Final Fantasy X, coming in 10th place. Isn't that interesting? For the PlayStation 2, of course. Now, this is your not so traditional, I guess you could say, video game opening. And what I mean by that is that they play heavy metal music rather than traditional, like, classical and stuff, which, again, most Final Fantasy openings. And it was definitely different. Of course, it shows Sin obviously appearing and gobbling up everything, of course. And we have, of course, Tidus getting ready to play some Blitzball, which is one of the most weird, made-up sports ever, I might add. Now, the interesting thing about it is the music. Most of the music is performed by the Japanese group called the Black Mages. And the vocals, interestingly enough, are done by Till Lindemann of Rammstein. Or, if you want to say Rammstein. But yes, so it's a very interesting combination, having the lead vocalist for Rammstein combined with the Japanese metal group of Black Mages doing Final Fantasy. Yeah, definitely you're not traditional. Coming in at number 9 is actually a tie. It was hard. The first of the two, exclusively on the PlayStation 2, and that is Tekken 5, which is definitely easily probably the coolest Tekken opening of the entire franchise. And trust me, Tekken's had some pretty awesome intros. Tekken 3 was pretty good. Tekken Tag was awesome. Tekken 4 was also pretty good. Tekken 6, not too bad. Dark Resurrection was also really good, which was just an alternate version of Tekken 5, but Tekken 5 was awesome. You really had two parts of the opening. First, you had, of course, the part at the temple with Heihachi Mishima and Kazuya Mishima battling the Jacks, which was pretty cool. You had Raven on the sidelines watching, which basically looked like Wesley Snipes' blade, more or less. And it says, Heihachi Mishima, dead. And then we go, showing for some reason, a girl on a bike jumping off a building to try catch a little kitten. And then we see flashes of multiple other characters and stuff going on. And of course, Nina and Anna trying to kill each other. But real enjoyable, and I like that they used heavy metal music. I thought it went really well with the atmosphere of Tekken 5. Tied with it, this game was released on the original Xbox, the PlayStation 2, the Nintendo GameCube, and the PSP. Though it went by a little bit of a different name on the PSP, but it was the same game. And of course, that is Mortal Kombat Deception, tied at 9. Mortal Kombat Deception is a really awesome, well-done opening because, I mean, you have a battle. The narrating's done by, of course, Shujinko, which debuts in that game. And The other cool thing about this particular game is, yeah, the opening we're introduced to the original Emperor of Outworld, Onaga, the Dragon King. And, yeah, Raiden, Quan Chi, and Shang Tsung, or Shang Tsung, however you want to pronounce it, tried their best, but were not able to face the Dragon King, Onaga. Excuse me for my yawning. Still early in filming right now at about like 7 a.m. So, anywho, coming at number 8 was originally released on the PS2 and then has special re-release in HD on the PS3. And that is from Square Enix / Disney Interactive. Kingdom Hearts 2, which would be, of course, our debut. Also with the new theme music, which of course is Sanctuary. Really good song, and the opening is awesome given it predominantly has Organization 13 in it. Organization 13 is pretty cool. And watching the entire opening just was really awesome, and show what was in store for you in Kingdom Hearts 2, which I felt surpassed the original Kingdom Hearts. And the original Kingdom Hearts, keep in mind, was really good. Coming in at number 7, released exclusively for the PC. I personally have not got to play the game, but it doesn't mean I didn't love the opening of the game. And that is Star Wars The Old Republic, which this game has somewhat based off the storyline of a book called Star Wars Old Republic Deceived, and it revolves obviously around Darth Malgus, which takes over and is taking over the planet of Mandalore, but also is trying to invade a planet you may have heard of before called Alderaan. Is also in this game, but it's a really awesome looking game. The voice acting is top-notch, and the overall quality, the cinematics are insanely good on this. And the music was top-notch. They used the music from the movies. Very amazing. For any Star Wars fan is going to really appreciate this opening for a game, and what of a way to open the game up. Coming in at number 6. Released on the PS3, the 360, and the PS Vita. Street Fighter Cross Tekken. Well, X, that's why I say Cross. And really awesome opening done by, the music is done by Black Tide, I believe is the name of the hard rock band that does the music. And I'm trying to remember the exact name of the song, but it's really good music. And I love the whole art style with showing like the water whatever look when they're moving around. It's very awesome. And I love the whole fight thing they were setting up in the video with Bison and Jin. And of course you see towards the end of the cinematic, Jin transforming into Devil Jin. And then we also have in it, like Ken and Ryu together against Kazuya Mishima. You also have in the cinematic opening of the game, awesome, like looking like they're getting ready to punch each other, Akuma, the badass of the Street Fighter series, and then Ogre, one heck of a badass boss from the Tekken franchise, which is one of the reasons why I think Tekken 3 was so awesome, was because of Ogre, / True Ogre. Coming in at number 5, for the original PlayStation. Though this is my personal favorite Final Fantasy game, this is how far it gets it. Actually, it's tied for 5th place. First, Final Fantasy 8. Which is awesome. The music is top-notch. And it's like sets up a lot of mysteries and stuff for it. And the music is really good. And the music ends up being the theme music for like Sorceress Ida, which is the first of three sorceresses in the game. Then you have Sorceress Abel, and then Sorceress Ultimacia. But Sorceress Ultimacia is basically manipulating the woman who becomes Sorceress Ida. She's nothing more than a pawn, basically. Tied with it, released on the PS3 and the 360. Final Fantasy 13-2. Opening was so amazing and gorgeous. The graphics were insane. I know graphics don't always matter, but I love the cinematic style of Square games. They're just awesome. Next up, coming in at number 4 for the Super Nintendo. So there you see. Not everything is always about graphics. Guess number 4 goes to a Super Nintendo game. Final Fantasy VI. And of course the piece of music to play is called Terry's Theme. And music is gorgeous. I think probably one of the 5 best pieces of music from the entire Final Fantasy franchise as a whole. Music is top notch, beautiful, and the cinematics, it's like a masterpiece in 16-bit glory. I think, personally, Final Fantasy VI or Final Fantasy III for Super Nintendo is perhaps the best JRPG of any 16-bit game, hands down the best JRPG on the Super Nintendo. There's no doubt in my mind, though some people might debate Chrono Trigger. Coming in at number 3 is another tie. Is a tie between Soul Blade for the original PlayStation, which is, of course, what debuted and would start off the Soul Calibur franchise. Soul Blade's music is really enjoyable, and I love the cinematics introducing all the characters like Leilong, Taki, Sulfitia, Siegfried, of course, Cervantes de Leon. And, of course, him taking off his face to show a skeleton head with fire, which, of course, is Inferno. But in the first game, he was just called Soul Edge. Very good. Overall, well done. Tied with it for the PS2. Soul Calibur 3. Exclusively. That's one heck of an exclusive, given it'll always Soul Calibur 3, maybe the best of the Soul Calibur series with the Soul Calibur name. Between that and probably Soul Calibur for the Dreamcast. It's interesting, the two best in the series were exclusives. 3 was incredible, the music was insanely good. Loved that they finally divided Nightmare from Siegfried. You have awesome debuts of new bosses like the souped-up version of Zossalamel, which debuted, which of course being Abyss. Which is sort of like a new type of version of like Inferno, but a little more powerful than even a non-Inferno, but yeah, the new head boss, but sort of like Nightmare in some ways because he's a souped-up, evil version. Coming in at number 2. Originally for the Nintendo 3DS, and it's going to begin an HD re-release on PS4 in a special collection. And it is from Disney Interactive and Square Enix, and that is Kingdom Hearts 3D, or rather Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance, which just has the orchestra version of Simple and Clean. Love the song, but I love the orchestra version. And you get to see characters from all the games leading up to Dream Drop Distance. I don't care what anybody says, it is a fair sequel to Kingdom Hearts 2. Storyline-wise, it is. And honorable mention before number 1. For the DS, and mobile, Final Fantasy 3. For GameCube, PS2, and Xbox, Soul Calibur 2. For PSP, and was re-released on PS3 HD. Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep. Tekken, 4. Also, we have Tekken Tag. Tekken Tag 2, Dark Resurrection. Okay, next, honorable mention, N64 and 3DS, Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. For DS and PSP, Final Fantasy IV. For PS2, Final Fantasy XII. For original PlayStation, Destrega. For PS3, Lightning Returns, Final Fantasy XIII. For Xbox/HD version on 360, Fable, which of course music was done by Danny Elfman. And for PS Vita and the re-release HD on PS4, Gravity Rush. And here it is, coming at number 1. Originally released on PSP, had HD version released in America for PS4 and Xbox One. Final Fantasy Type Zero HD, or just Final Fantasy Type Zero. In some ways, I think the overall voice work with the lips and stuff was better in the Japanese dub, but I still like the overall voice actors they used in the English dub was good. And you see this interesting world and stuff. And you find out that Final Fantasy Type-Zero takes place in the exact same world as, I believe, Final Fantasy... What is it, I read? I think it takes place in the same world as Final Fantasy XII or something like that. And, of course, we are introduced, they show, like, the debut symbols for the four kingdoms of this world. And the flying spaceships in it look almost identical to, from the anime series, Last Exile, the battleships and stuff in that, which I thought was kind of cool. And then we have the awesome music towards the end, where we see these, Aeons. Was it a summon Idorans? Idorans, if I remember correctly, is how they said it. But yes, it's an amazing cinematic opening for any video game. Man, it blew me away the first time I saw Final Fantasy Type-Zero opening. I was like, holy crap. The music is just top-notch, and I expect nothing less of Final Fantasy to have incredible music. But leave a comment below, tell me what you thought, send me feedback, ideas. Also, what is your favorite video game openings? And if you have more than one, what's your favorite Square Enix game opening? Please thumbs up this video, subscribe, and let us know about my channel. And I'll see y'all here next time in YouTube land. Same YouTube time, same YouTube channel. And I thought I would choose a video game pick of the week for that I recommend if you've never played to check out. And this for the first suggestion is for the Xbox 360. It's an exclusive JRPG called Lost Odyssey. If you get a chance, check it out. Anyways, I'll see y'all soon enough here again. Have a great upcoming Monday. And a great May.